have the time to cover so many of them. There's so many issues that are of interest and concern. But one of them that we must say a few words on is the continuing rise in the gas prices. We believe that this is an issue which we cannot afford to forget, because it continues to impact upon the population in a very real and substantial way. You would know that from June to April, when the gas prices were changed, Grenada's gas prices at the pump went up to a price, remained at a price. In fact, the gap between the price in Grenada and the other countries actually widened within the last month. And whereas the price of a gallon of gas was $12.30 as of March the 18th, today a gallon of gas sells in Grenada for $13.20. And that compares with a price of $10.50 in St. Vincent, $12.50 in Antigua, $10.22 in St. Kitts, $9.92 in St. Lucia, and $9.39 in Dominica. This means that on average, Grenada's gas prices are $2.73 more than the average price for anywhere in the OECS sub-region. Grenada's price is on average 25% higher than in the other territories. And so, to put it in another form, the quantity of gas that Grenadians are paying $100 for today, Dominica and the other countries are paying $75 for that same quantity of gas when they go to the pumps. So what we get, what they're getting $75 for, in terms of the quantity of gas, we have to pay $100 for it. This is how bad the situation is. The situation is particularly worrying and troublesome because the petroleum that we're talking about is purchased from Trinidad. Grenada is transported by ship from Trinidad of the islands. Grenada is the closest island to Trinidad and Tobago, of all the islands. And so in terms of transportation costs is lower for Grenada than for any other island. Imagine the country, as some people say, closest to the church but further from God. You know, we are right here, but we are paying the most for it. And this situation really is not justified. 18 months ago, a barrel of oil sold for $143 US. At that time, let me see, gas prices in Grenada was $16 a gallon. Today, the price of a barrel of gas is just about $40. And when you look at the price, it has only fallen from $16 to $13.20. Yeah? So the situation is really not justified. And this is happening because the government continues to impose a very burdensome tax situation on the population. In every other country in the OECS, the petroleum tax is $3 per gallon. Here, it is $5.50 a gallon on the tax. So what is happening in effect is that the government is gouging the citizens, and they are making up to $41.5 million a year from gasoline sales in the country. The government is boasting that it is collecting more monies now than ever. In fact, one of the ministers was on TV not long ago saying that in the month of March, they realized more revenues than they've ever realized. So at a time when the government said it is collecting more monies than ever, it is still continuing to gouge the citizens of Grenada. And we are calling on the government once again to lower the price, lower the tax on petroleum and petroleum products, so that the gas can be sold at a more reasonable price to the population. It is affecting all commuters that use the buses to come to work on a daily basis. It is affecting the owners of vehicles traveling to and from work and to and from church and to and from other businesses that they have to engage in. It is dropping their kids to and from school. It is affecting the businesses themselves because the cost of fuel impacts on the cost of production. And so this situation is having a negative effect, a negative impact on economic activity in the country. And this is the point that we continue to make, that the taxes, the burden of taxes that the government has put on the country is so high that it is actually having the opposite effect than what it should be having. It's suffocating the economy. And so we're calling on the government to lower the petroleum tax, bring it down to a reasonable price, so that we can benefit, as the rest of the world is benefiting, we can benefit from the crisis that we've experienced. So that's the first issue I want to make a very quick comment.